I'm Dr. Dong-Seok Son. I'm oral and maxillofacial surgeon who works for Catholic University Medical Center of Daegu. I'm very pleased to share my clinical video of Flapless crestal approach using hydrodynamic piezoelectric internal sinus elevation. A 53-year-old female patient presented with missing right posterior first molar. The panoramic view of combeam CT shows you no pathology in the right maxillary sinus. This is cross-sectional view of combeam CT at the site of a missing first molar. This radiographic image shows you about 9 mm bone height and 8 mm bone width. So, Flapless H-piece technique using autologous concentrated growth factors was planned in order to minimize postoperative patient discomfort. Intraoral view shows you sufficient attached keratinized gingiva at the implant site, so this case is good indication for Flapless surgery. Even bone architecture was confirmed by combeam CT, bone mapping was performed to verify any undercut on the buccal wall of alveolar bone. A 4 mm wide soft tissue punch attached with handpiece of implant mold was utilized with copious saline irrigation to remove soft tissue. A soft tissue core was removed from alveolar bone by using curette and hemostat. Remaining soft tissue on the alveolar bone was completely removed out by using small curette. A periodontal probe was utilized to measure gingival depth at medial, distal, buccal, and palatal area. A round carbide tip attached with ultrasonic device surge bone was utilized to break sinus floor directly. Thanks to micrometric cut effect and selective cut effect, the rate of membrane perforation is very low after breaking sinus floor. When approaching sinus floor with round carbide tip, the tip should be moved in circular motion or bone scraping motion in order to prevent mechanical membrane perforation. The 2.8 mm wide H-piece tip was then used to advance the osteotomy to end through the sinus floor. Hydraulic pressure was applied for a few tense seconds to gently elevate the membrane. The sinus floor was broken with H-piece tip. Please note the water coming out from sinus cavity after elevation of sinus mucosa. The H-piece tip is a final osteotomy tip to accommodate 3.7 to 4.2 mm wide tapered designed implant with good initial stability. Autologous concentrated growth factors were prepared by using special centrifuges made PUGE. These fibrin-rich gels were inserted in the U compartment under the elevated sinus mucosa in order to accelerate new bone formation in the sinus. This fibrin-rich gel is known to release slowly growth factors such as transforming growth factor, platelet-derived growth factor, and vascular endothelial growth factors. These growth factors accelerate newborn formation in the sinus and reduce healing period. According to some clinical studies, bone graft material is not be a prerequisite for sinus augmentation. Some studies prove that insertion of fibrin-rich gel with concentrated growth factors as alternative to bone graft and simultaneous implant placement showed successful newborn formation in the sinus and can be a predictable prognosis for sinus augmentation. In order to facilitate insertion of fibrin-rich gel and wide body implant placement, 3.8 mm wide intermediate implant drill was utilized to expand implant site. The widening of implant site made the insertion of fibrin-rich gel easy into the new compartment under the elevated sinus mucosa. A dental pincet is a good carrier to insert fibrin-rich gel into the osteotomy site. A speech tip is a good instrument to push the fibrin-rich gel into the sinus. All osteotomy can be used to push the fibrin-rich gel into the sinus cavity. Totally, 3 pieces of autologous fibrin gel were inserted in the sinus. A 4.7 wide, 11.5 high HA-coated implant was inserted, but the initial stability was not good due to poor bone density. Even undersized osteotomy was performed. So this implant was removed out. A 6 mm wide and 11.5 mm high HA-coated taped screw bent implant was selected and placed with good initial stability. An implant mount was removed. The position of implant platform was measured by using periodontal probe. This implant was placed supracrestally slightly. Latchet adapter was positioned on the implant. An implant was placed subcrestally by using wrench. A healing abutment was positioned on the implant platform as a one-stage procedure. The panoramic view of Convim CT shows approximately 15 mm high membrane elevation. Unlike conventional osteotomy techniques showing localized dome-shaped sinus elevation, HPS technique induces broad and gentle elevation of sinus membrane as the same as lateral window technique. As shown on this video, the HPS technique does not rely on manual instrumentation or bone compaction to elevate sinus membrane. This is the cross-sectional view of Convim CT, showing broad elevation of sinus mucosa buccopalatally. This is comparison of preoperative and postoperative radiographic image. HPS technique could be an alternative surgical method to the lateral sinus augmentation technique. However, the postoperative discomfort is very minimal compared to the lateral window technique. Thank you very much for your kind attention.